intimate crowd here, we could just talk straight up. the concept is conduction. It's a concept that was founded by Butch Morris. I worked with Butch Morris for over, I guess we knew each other and I worked with him for about 25 years off and on. But at the beginning, I was there when Butch just came back to New York and started trying to enroll all these musicians in this idea. And as you can imagine, it was up and down. You know, some people didn't want to buy in. Folks knew it too much. Some folks didn't know enough. And eventually, I will fast forward that to a concert, one of the last concerts we did in Sardinia, 2013, I believe that was. And we had like 20 musicians, all the best guys in that postmodern jazz discipline. And he really figured that thing out. And that also convinced me. And just before he passed away, I told him I'm going to work with this. And he said, please. So he's left us a great tool. It's a way of creating cohesive composition, cohesive ideas, more than three people. See, once you get past three, you got traffic jams, right? And in jazz, we always want to create the impulse of freshness, the impulse of theme and variation. So rather than always having to write out all the notes, which is a great way to do it, but we've done that for a long time, and part of jazz, going against what may be popular now of what a purist is. A purist within, let's say conduction thinking and also within the thinking of mind, a purist is somebody within jazz who's constantly reinventing. If you're not constantly reinventing, you're not a purist. So to be a revivalist and to match that purism is rationally not possible. Okay? So this is what we're going to try to do. Thank you very much for coming. I see some heavyweights out here, so I'm good. Here we go. Now we are going to mix up some older tunes and work into conduction. And the purpose of that is, not to throw people out in the water. You know, can't swim. Just like, that's part of it. But it's also part to understand the distance of what conduction is doing. You know the songs, and you can see the distance in which we're traveling. And I think that's interesting. Okay, here we go. Dolores, come on.
Thank you. Thank you.
So a very important component of what we're doing, it's not only in conduction, but in a whole train of thought of creativity, is that instead of putting students in a situation where there's a pretext of what jazz is, riffs, and this kind of things, we're actually putting them on the same plane of creation that all of therefore, we do use some rhythms that of this generation that people are feeling. Conduction is definitely about using the vocabulary you have right now. And also, it's about a very important part of music, and I call that the middle ground. The middle ground, which means you have the head, the music, and then you have the solos. There's all this stuff in the middle, like dynamics. Like you could actually do a solo just with loud and soft. You could do a solo with one guy laying out and somebody playing. It's just about variation. Human beings are sensitive to variation, and that's all a solo is. That's what all a solo is. But let's not take it too far, right? So there's a time and point when people are able to solo. We don't need that. We just need to get them to understand the middle ground. If you look at it as a pyramid, we're building the base, and we're building the middle ground. And we keep looking at the top. If you want to learn the scales and do all that, you can do that too. But we can create right now. So all what you heard outside of the standards were the creations that they did, that they came up with themselves. And they got, copyright, whatever. Here we go. Also a very important thing about the music business, right? All right. In this piece, we're gonna, very proficient musicians in this room, we're gonna feature Kartik Jan's tune 105. Did I mention your last name right, Jan?
Jane.
Kartik Jane, the guitarist, has an original composition 105, and we're also going to feature Benjamin Green's composition on tenor saxophone called Waltz for Thudi. Waltz for Thudi. I'd like to meet that person.
She's adorable.
Awesome. So these are real people with real inspirations. Here we go. Reaction time, right? Keep it here. One, two. Thank you.
Thank you. Imagine what life could be if you had a dream like